Hi guys, in today's teardown, this piece of Soviet-made avionics, it seems we have an air data converter which is calculating the speed, airspeed, from air inlet coming from pitot tubes and converting it to an electrical signal, either analog or digital, probably analog. So this thing is called DVS-10, serial number 4779. Here you have a dial where you can see the speed in kilometers per hour times 100. So as you can see, we have two parts on this device. Well, maybe even more parts. We have this black cylinder, black backlight cylinder, where most of the stuff happens. We have this support bracket with shock absorbers. And here at the bottom, we have a box with some electronics. So here you can see how the cylinder is attached to the frame with its metal clamps. Here we have some information written in red. Seems it can go up to 1,350 kilometers per hour. Other piece of information here. Not sure what it says. Here you can see the mounting plate to the aircraft. So for accessing this box, it will require removing this plate and unbolting this washer, these nuts here with spanner screwdriver. And I think I will be able to open this box. About the cables, you have the main cable here with a connector. And it goes, in fact, inside the drum here. And here you have another piece of wire getting out of this and going in the bottom part. So for ease of teardown, I will probably cut the wires at some point inside this. Cut them in order to be able to reinstall them if needed later, but anyway, this thing is never going to be used again. You have here a nice big crack in the plastic backlight housing, sadly. Maybe I will try to reinforce a little bit from the inside before I reassemble this. So first we will have access to this bottom box. I did already take this apart previously, but there is a long time and I do not remember exactly. If I remember correctly, I must remove this mounting plate with a bigger screwdriver, like so. So you have here nice shock absorbers with rubber pieces and springs inside. Here we are, and it seems I have a screw here at least I can undo with a factory seal cup, as always. Try to not lose any screw. So we have this piece. I do not remember if I must undo these ones or the top ones here, and I believe I must remove the top ones. Here we have a regular nut. If I can undo this. Is it coming off? Not sure. And here we need a spanner screwdriver. Luckily I have one from, yes it is coming off, from an old mobile phone maintenance toolkit. And it is really convenient and it is not really easy to find. I had even at some point I needed to make one from a regular screwdriver for something because you cannot get them. So here is one removed. Other side. So here I have a spanner nut too, so maybe at some point I did open it and it was just missing the nut. And replace it with a regular one. So it is really a pain to undo this thing. Yes, the piece did fall at the bottom. So now I just have this one to finish undoing. Will it come off? Not easy. Yes, here we are. It did fall on the ground. So, and this is coming off. So yes, as you can see in here, so maybe I will try to avoid cutting the wire. I will remove the drum and I will leave it attached. It is not too too big problem. So as you can see, we have here what seems to be two toroidal transformers. Regular shape transformer or inductors here. Here at the bottom we have components in heat shrink, probably. According to the size, I should guess it is capacitors. And here we have a whole bunch of diodes. 11 diodes, it seems. Some precision wire wound resistors, trim pot here. Okay, here is a zoomed in view for you before we go to the next part. Not much here, by the way. Okay, now I will remove the drum part from the stand. So it is just a matter of undoing the two metal clamps. Which open nicely as you can see, and this screw is loose proof. It is nice. So the other one. And it is raining again outside. Okay. So here we are. You can see it did come off quite easily. Here we have some piece of rubber to accommodate the thing. And now here we have, you can see it is in two parts. So there is this factory seal screws, but they do not seal anything. You can remove them by hand. Because usually there is a little notch in this, preventing them to turn, but not here. And now I can first remove this front cover. I do not remember if I did already do a repair work inside the crack or not. Here we are. This front cover, yes, should come off. Yes, there is a piece of sticky tape inside. Okay. And now you can see the dial piece. It is really, really nice. And seems we have a whole bunch of, it makes noise when I turn it, wire wound resistors all around. Four of them, so I guess they have parts that encode the speed on display here. Then next, if I want to continue, so here we have air inputs with nuts around them. I do not know if I will need or not to remove the nuts. So first, let's try to undo this part. I do not remember taking this apart this far. At least I did, for sure I did remove this cover here, but this back one, I do not know. I do not remember of what there is inside at all, by the way. So, if it is possible to take it apart, it will be interesting. Here is no more screw, and it is coming off like so. I would like to be able to put it back together. In the same way it came off. So let's do why that here and here. It will be enough, I guess. Okay, so this part, as you can see, we have a whole bunch of wires coming from the wire harness here, the plug. Here at the bottom we have what seems to be wire wound precision resistors. And here in the middle there must be some synchro encoder, synchro transmitter, something like this. So here is the active part inside this drum. I need to find a way to loosen this ring, so I will be back. Okay guys, looks we are in, well we will be in. I did disconnect these three wires here for having a better access to the thing. I will put this on the side. And now I did use my big spanner wrench from Banggood. I did stick it in the vise and I did turn the drum, and it allowed to release this big ring which I am undoing for the very first time, because previously I didn't have a spanner wrench, so I was not able to undo it. It should come off by hand now. Almost. Probably we will have some O-ring. I hope it will not be too sticky. This kind of parts is always a pain to undo. And in fact impossible to undo if you haven't got the proper tools. So here we are. So will it come off? I do not know. Seems it does not want to come off, I guess. We have to remove the bolts here. So these are, the nuts here are 14 millimeters. By the way, seems Russia need like a lot, 14 millimeters nuts. If you want to tinker Soviet made stuff, you will need 14 millimeter wrench to do the work. Okay, will it come off now? It should, but it seems we have some seal around here. I am able to undo this thing first, yes. And here at least we have a seal, so let's try gently to push this, and this part here did come off inside. at least. Not this one, I guess we have a seal. Oops, something did that. No, it did not break it, it just the seal that did hang up. But still no help because I cannot remove this part here. Seems it is sealed in place. So I do not know in fact if it was necessary or not to do it because this is a static input anyway. So maybe it is not used in the instrument. Can I move this, maybe, a little bit? It's really stuck in place with... Ah, here we are. This did come off. Now I have a seal here. And I have more parts, so I'm not sure if I am supposed to remove these two little screws or remove this middle piece. With 5.5 millimeter key, something did fall inside. So I guess it was not the proper way, okay? Now we try to remove two small screws then. They are very, very, very small. Putting this thing together will be really a piece of cake, I feel. Off. No. I guess there is another O-ring somewhere. No, it's coming off. And I am really annoyed with these wires. Here we are. Okay. So I can see the piece I did tamper with, which I was not supposed to touch. And I can see two screws attaching the insides. So same here, I will take note of how it was fixed. Like so. And cleaning a little bit the mess. I can see two screws at the back here. If I can remove them, I may be able to at least remove the internal parts. It will be really fun to put back together, guys. So I think we are in, more or less. Okay, we have two layers of stuff, as you can see, one here and one over at the back, which I need to remove if I want to see if I did break anything here. So what do we have here? First I will put back this thing in place. Here is a So as you can see, there is an aneroid capsule. Is it the word to call it, I guess? Aneroid capsule, moving little mechanism, as you can see here, and one more potentiometer. Wire one potentiometer. And here we have a whole armada of wire wound resistors. So I will put this back in place, so I know it is not the correct way to take this apart. Okay, so we have one here, and at the back we have a second time the same thing. So same thing, I need to keep track of the position for reassembly. Put these screws on the side, cleaning a little bit the dust falling out of it. And here I have one screw. Oh, this one will be fun to put back in place, I guess. Really painful probably, because it is deep inside. Second screw. And the second part should come off, I guess. More or less, maybe. I see only two screws. Looks like it did move a little bit. Yes, it is coming off now. And here we are. So as you can see, second time the same thing. Here at the back, I did not break anything in fact. It is just the case connection to air pressure. So I did just break airtight seal, so it is not a big deal. I will immediately put back the nut on this one. Then I will know how it comes back together. Okay. A good cleaning of all this before reassembly will be good idea. So what where were we at? Yes, so this second unit, as you can see, is exactly the same, well, pretty much a copy of this one. Yes, with the same set of precision resistors. As you can see, this wire wound resistors, I am even in the frame, yes. This wire wound resistor is a multi-tap wire wound, it seems. And here the little wiper. So this is interesting. Small mechanism here. And all these precision resistors. Seems a lot of them are wired in a series. Aneroid capsule. And this one is connected to the static air inlet, which I did bent a little bit, but not too a big deal, too much a big deal. Okay, so it is how it works. So for sure it is completely analog, no integrated circuits in this, just potentiometers, resistors, and some kind of transformers here, I guess. This part here must be for the synchro transmitter, maybe, we have in here. Okay, so here are all the insides of Soviet airspeed encoder. Do we have any dead code before I wrap up this video? In order to see how old it is. I have a 0280 here, so it must be early 80s design, as you can guess, nothing very sophisticated here, good basic techniques that work, at least, nice die-cast aluminium parts, as you can see, this also. And a lot of wires and a lot of stuff. Okay, so now I will try to put this back together, maybe. Thanks for watching.